In this video, we're going to discuss finding absolute maximums and minimums. When can we guarantee that we have an absolute maximum and an absolute minimum for a given function on a given interval? Well, let's look at some of these examples. For this first example, we do have an absolute minimum here and an absolute maximum here, so this is a good one. For the second example, we have no absolute minimum or maximum, so that's bad. The third example, it goes up forever, but it never gets an absolute maximum y value. And as it comes down here, it's closer and closer to this open dot. So if this open dot was filled in, it would be an absolute minimum. But since it's not filled in, there's no absolute maximum or absolute minimum in this example. This example has an absolute maximum here and an absolute minimum here. This example has an absolute maximum, but there is again no absolute minimum because the lowest point is approaching an open dot. This absolute value example has an absolute minimum, but no absolute maximum because these keep going up. And this last example does have an absolute minimum at this endpoint and an absolute maximum at this endpoint. So what does that mean? It means we can split our graphs into these two groups. This group on this side has an absolute maximum and an absolute minimum. This group over here does not. So what do all of the functions on this side have in common? Well, let's see. They're all on closed intervals. Do you see that? They all have endpoints. So that's like this, a to b with closed brackets. This one doesn't have a closed interval, so that would take care of that one. This one doesn't have a closed interval, so it would take care of that one. This one doesn't have a closed interval, so it would take care of that one. But this one right here is actually defined on a closed interval because it starts up here, goes all the way down here, and it goes to this closed dot right here. So the problem with this graph is that it's not continuous. So we need continuous on a closed interval. If f is continuous on a closed interval, then it has to have an absolute maximum and an absolute minimum on that interval. This is called the extreme value theorem. So we can use the extreme value theorem to actually find the absolute maximum, absolute minimum values of a continuous function on a closed interval. So here's a continuous function, here's a closed interval. We know it must have an absolute maximum and an absolute minimum. So how do we find them? If we go back and we look at our examples again, the absolute maximums either occur, and the absolute minimums either occur at the endpoints, or they're occurring in the middle at the local maxes and mins. And this should make really good sense. The only way you can be the biggest is if you're at the endpoints or you're the biggest nearby. So that's step one. The absolute max and min must occur at endpoints or critical points. So we're going to find them. And then step two is, of these endpoints and critical points, the one with the biggest y value is the absolute max, and similarly, the one with the smallest y value is the absolute min. So find the y values. All right, so let's try this for this given example. All right, so we need to find the critical points and the endpoints. The endpoints are easy, they're given to us. The critical points are where the derivative is zero or undefined, so we're going to find the derivative, and that's 3x squared minus 6x. It's a polynomial, so it's never undefined. We're going to set it equal to zero. We'll factor out an x, and we have 3x minus 6. This means that when x is zero, we have a critical point, and when 3x minus 6 is 0, we have a critical point. So that's when 3x equals 6, or x equals 2. So we have two critical points at 0 and 2, and two endpoints at negative 1/2 and 4. So what we need to do now is find the y values that go with each of these things. We need to find f of negative 1/2, f of 0, f of 2, and finally f of 4. Whichever of these y values is biggest, that's the value of our absolute maximum, and whichever y value is the smallest, that's the value of our absolute minimum. So x cubed minus 3x squared plus 1. So we have negative 1/2 cubed minus 3 negative 1/2 squared plus 1, which turns out to be 1/8. Then we have 0 cubed minus 3 times 0 squared plus 1, which is 1. And then we have 2 cubed minus 3 times 2 squared plus plus 1, which is negative 3. And finally, 4 cubed minus 3 times 4 squared plus 1, which is 17. So we can see that the smallest number here of the 1/8, 1, negative 3, and 17 is negative 3. So this is our absolute min, which occurs in an x value of 2. And the biggest of these numbers is 17. So this is our absolute max, which occurs when x is 4. So you can see that you can always find absolute maximums and minimums if you have a continuous function on a closed interval by finding all the critical points and then evaluating the function at the critical points and the endpoints and taking your largest and smallest y values, and these are your absolute maximum and absolute minimum.